All right, joining us now on Hot Copy, we have with us Lanao del Sur Representative Zia Alonto Adyong. He is also a member on the House Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability. Representative Adyong, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen, and thank you for having me.
All right, so let's start first with this. The House panel has extended the detention order for Zulaika Lopez. She is the Chief of Staff of Vice President Sara Duterte. This extension, of course, has led the Vice President to protest it, questioning already if the House Committee is violating her human rights. So let's start with that. How long is the House panel extending the detention order? Ang nabasa namin from 5 days to 10 days.
Yes, Karen, the maximum maximum duration na for any person cited in contempt would be 10 days according to our rules. This is brought out by the violation that was in the previous hearing that was invoked by Franz Castro, Congresswoman Franz Castro, for undue interference in the ongoing inquiry in aid of legislation, which the Good Committee on Good Government is currently conducting in relation to the questionable disbursement of the confidential funds of the Office of the Vice President, that is at the same time the Department of Education. So yes, it could be extended to 10 days, maximum would be 10 days. But I believe Attorney Zulaika is under hospital detention. She is currently admitted at the Veterans Medical Center in Quezon City.
Okay, so the Vice President has already stated that the lower house is violating Zulaika's personal liberties, her civil liberties, her human rights, right? The Supreme Court came out with a decision sometime in 2023 stating, of course, that Congress's power to detain is subject to three limitations, right? I'm sure you've read this. And let me read the third one. It's the person's detention should only last until the termination of the legislative inquiry. So ang tanong, itong 10 days ninyo, does this violate that precept of the Supreme Court that it should only last until the termination of the legislative inquiry? Would you be extending 10 days?
Yeah, actually, the thing, Karen, is we don't have an exact date when we're going to end the committee hearing in the inquiry, no? Indefinitely, because as we go along, if you watch yesterday's committee hearing, there are a lot of personalities and names mentioned. We have names which were not mentioned in the previous hearings, which I believe are now being requested to attend in the next committee inquiry. So it's an evolving issue, Karen. Yeah. So we don't exactly know when the end of the investigation will happen, simply because even those four accountable officers that they finally showed up, Ms. Gina Acosta, the Fajardo couples, and Tenorio, they even said, you know, we have, yes, we in the manner by which we do our job is compartmentalized. And this supported the earlier pronouncement of Attorney Poa and Attorney Zulaika, simply because they do not, for example, SDO Fajardo, when we ask him, well, who do you give the money when you encash the 37 million pesos? These are three tranches, right? And he told us, well, I give the money to Certain Nolasco. No? And so Certain Nolasco is not, his name was never popped up during the previous hearing. So we have to get to that point where we can finally say that there are violations committed under the joint circular. And what are these violations? And what are these overlapping functions that I personally think is one of the causes why there are so many disconnections and so many, you know, finger pointing. Ms. Gina Acosta saying, I do not know anything about this. I was charged to just encash the check and then give this particular person. And who gave you the order? They all point up to the Vice President. So until such time that we can finally clear out all the, you know, all the questions and all the unanswered, you know, issues and concerns relative to the disbursement and usage of the confidential funds. We really couldn't say when will the committee hearing would last. But according to our rules, the maximum days would put a person cited in contempt under our rules is 10 days.
Okay, now let's talk about what was discovered in the hearing. To remind the viewers, the hearing is essentially about this. How is the vice president spending her confidential funds, right?
Exactly.
That is the whole basis of this hearing. So what we've discovered based on the few hearings you've had is, number one, ginagastos sa safe house, no? Ginagastos sa safe house, naubod ng mahal ang presyo ng safe house, at hindi sapat ang impormasyon sa mga acknowledgement receipts, yung tumatanggap ng pera sa safe house, number one. Number two, ang nadiskubre ngayon is checks of 37 million pesos issued. How many checks were those?
Three checks.
So roughly, yeah. To 100 million pesos ito, right? 100 million pesos in cash.
112.5 million to be exact.
Okay. And saan daw napupunta yun?
Exactly. That's what we're trying to solicit from SDO Fajarda. Because SDO Fajarda is the one whose name is appeared on these three checks. Ibig sabihin, siya yung payee. I mean, siya yung nakapangalan sa kanya, yung check-in, ng land bank.
And who is this person, representative?
He is the special disbursement officer of the Office of the Department of Office of the under okay. The Office of the Secretary of Department of Education. This is the SDO is actually a position created born out of the joint circular memorandum circular to cover the expenses of the confidential funds for each of the agencies.
Wait, representative, so we're talking about the confidential funds of the VP, not the Deputy Secretary.
That's the DepEd. That's the Department of Education. We're not talking about the OVP. The OVP, the SDO for the OVP is Ms. Gina Acosta.
Oo. Pero ang tanong ko nga, ang pinag-uusapan ngayon ay ang confidential funds ng OVP.
Hindi po. Currently, what we're discussing right now is
the confidential funds
for the Department of Education.
So, yes.
And this is very much interconnected, Karen. Kasi it happened, the releases for each of the confidential funds happened within a certain time frame. Magkasunod to . Remember, we're talking of 500 million confidential funds for the Office of the Vice President and at the same time, 112.5 million for the Office of the Department of Education, Secretary of the Department of Education. At this time, the Vice President currently, at the time, he was holding this concurrent.
Okay, but just very quickly, all right, because the Quad Committee hearing is in other words, each and every day there's nagmi-mix, no, yung confidential funds discussion. So pero itong DepEd na 150 million ang confidential funds niya, you've discovered that three checks of 37 million pesos were issued amounting to 112 million. At ang tanong, did they issue a report where they spent it? Yung DepEd Confi funds muna.
Yeah, actually the utilization report was submitted. We also had that document, the utilization. Kasi before you can encash the check, meron kasing pinipirmahan, and that's where Ms. Sunshine Fajarda comes in. Because Ms. Sunshine Fajarda is the wife of Edward Fajarda, and she is the assistant secretary during the time when VP Sara was the then Secretary of Education. And she's in charge of collecting and securing signatures because according to her, the Vice President would not sign any document without her handing the document personally to the Vice President. And so there's the disbursement, special disbursement order before they can encash that for the release of the checks. Now, ito po yung mga na-signatory dito in the checks, Ms. Civiliana and Ms. Yusek, the one that was asked to resign by attorneys like
that.
Ito si Yusek, syempre nagsasabi na she been receiving envelopes.
Oo.
From Sunshine for
Hard. Na mga 50,000. 50,000 pesos na envelopes. Tama?
Yes, exactly.
A month.
Yeah, and it's the same narrative that was also revealed to us by Ms. Catalan, you know, the account that he's also a signatory. Before you can actually in cash, you need all the signatures by these individuals. You know?
Okay.
The question is, how come, according to them, they're receiving a month envelopes from Ms. Fajardo? When we ask about Ms. Fajardo whether she indeed give out envelopes for these two particular persons, particularly Ms. Catalan, she did not respond to us either. She did not confirm nor deny. She just simply said, this is not the proper forum to discuss about that. So basically, she was invoking her right against self-incrimination. To me, that's an indication that she did not confirm that, admit that, but still, it leaves us a very, you know, it leaves us, or it even reinforces our own personal question that perhaps maybe there's something wrong in the distribution and the way they handle of these funds. Yes. Apart from releasing it.
I think so. It's clear. Clearly, the vice president has been using her confidential funds, right? Whether the office of the OVP, she's been releasing it. The office of the DepEd, she's been releasing it. Sa DepEd, ang tanong nga, saan ginastos? Okay, it's a given. They were disbursing it. E binigay niyo eh. I always say this, hindi ba kasalanan din ng Kongreso? Kayo rin naman ang nagbigay sa kanya ng ganyang kalaking confidential funds. I always say that in interviews. At the end of the day, what would you expect? Right? Why would the Office of the Vice President need 500 or 600 million for the office, 150 for the DepEd? All of you gave it to her, frankly speaking, right? Okay, so ang tanong, where did they spend it? Yung DepEd muna, sir. Saan daw?
Okay, first, we approved the confidential funds in good faith. We thought the Office of the Vice President and the Department of Education Secretary will be spending the confidential funds according to the joint memorandum circular. The reason why we're also reviewing the GAA of 2022, 2023, up to 2024, a portion of 2024, is precisely because we want to exercise the oversight function. For us to realize, according to the TOA AOMs and the notice of disallowances, hey guys, something is wrong with the utilization of these funds. And so that by next time, you will not be able to just simply give out confidential funds to those agencies who have been requesting the House to provide them such amount for confidential funds. Now, to the next question, ma'am, that's exactly what the question
of... None of them have answered something as simple as, where did the 37 million go?
Exactly.
There's
no clear answer. Kasi ang sinasabi po ni, for example, SDO Fajardo, ang sabi niya is, I give this to certain Olasco. I don't know, Captain Olasco, and maybe we ask him, why do you have to delegate that power to a single person according to the joint
statement? No, so where did he give it? Where did he spend it?
That's exactly what we want to find out, because we have an acknowledgement receipts. And the acknowledgement receipts, which appears to have one name, same spelling, signed by apparently different person, obviously because of the different strokes of the signatures. That's why we had to seek the assistance of NBI. Also, it could not be corroborated clearly by Nolasco by explaining to us, because he's the special disbursement officer. He is in charge of handling these funds. He knows where these funds are being distributed, dispersed. He said he just gave it to Nolasco. And then when further questions were asked, he just simply say, well, it's very unclear, because he said that we spend this, it's only Nolasco who knows how to spend it. And then I was there, and then it's basically, Karen, Basically,
and then Nolasco is not a government official.
Apparently, according to him, he is a member of the security agency. I believe he is a captain. Colonel. Yeah, he has a rank.
Was he with the military?
If I'm not mistaken, yes. I think he's a military because on the OVP, it was also a name also was mentioned by Miss Gina Acosta, certain Colonel La Chica.
So one thing is clear. Yes, okay. So what we're seeing right now overall is after the investigation that the House has been conducting, is at some point the confidential funds of the Vice President goes into the hands of military men.
According to the testimonies.
Sources have said that confidential funds of the Vice President, there were doubts that it was being spent for other purposes such as destabilization. Is there enough information on that?
No, I haven't. Actually, we haven't heard the angle or the issue of probably using that for destabilization. I think as of now we are settling with what we have currently in our hands.
Okay.
The documents and the testimonies of our resources. We haven't heard anybody from among our guests saying or insinuating that it could have been this way. Yeah.
Yes. But that would never come out most likely in Congress, right?
I hope not, because yes. Destabilization okay. is a serious matter.
Yes. Okay, one thing is clear. The CONFI funds of the OVP and CONFI funds as DepEd Secretary, they landed in the hands of two military men, right? A Captain Nolasco for DepEd, and who was the one in the OVP?
I heard La Chica. I'm not too sure about the rank. Because when the question and the answer, well, I wasn't actually there. I went to the other committee hearing, but I went back. Okay. And that's what I heard, yeah.
So, ang tanong ko na lang ito. Ito munang Captain Nolasco. Is Captain Nolasco in charge of disbursing it out again? Because that's 100 million.
It appears to be that way, because that's according to the testimony of Fajardo. That's why we've been pressing Fajardo. How come you're designating this job? Which is actually designated to you, because you cannot delegate something which is delegated to you in the first place.
Yeah. So and Captain Nolasco, is he assigned or employed in the DepEd? What is official function?
We actually do not know. I personally do not know. That's why there was a motion to invite the certain Nolasco. I'm not really sure about the rank.
Yeah.
There was already a move by the committee that he will be sent an invitation, and hopefully by the next hearing, he'll show up.
Okay. And because what's alarming, essentially, number one is how confidential funds are spent. Number two, the process in which they're spent. Number three, the auditing and accountability of how you spend them. But number four, why would it land in the hands of military men?
That's what we're trying to figure out, Karen, no? Confidential funds, you know, maybe because of the term in itself, that is a certain, you know.
No, but why would you need military men to handle confidential funds?
Exactly, because that's the question that we want to, an answer that we want to solicit and find out. Because we remember, the Office of the Vice President and the Department of Education, these are all civilian agencies, right?
Yeah.
And they are guided, governed by the joint memorandum circular. And there are criteria for how to exactly spend the confidential funds. So once you go beyond that, or even probably missteps in the way you handle these funds, number one is why do you delegate this job as a special disbursement officer to another person? Because that's your primary.
Okay, I think we've lost Representative. Are you back? Go on.
Yeah.
Okay. So continue, sir. Continue.
So that's number one. There's a clear violation, even in the way that it was handled by SDO. But when we ask about SDO Fajardo, Edward, he always points out to the vice president, because that's the, you know, that's the I guess that's the order and the advice of the vice president to hand this over to Nolasco, certain Nolasco. That's number one violation. Number two is because of the ERs. They cannot even corroborate that with an actual account. You know, give us the narrative. How come, according to these ARs, some personality like Mary Grace Tiatos appears to have signed and received a certain amount from the confidential fund? So there are a lot of...
Mary Grace Tiatos, let's talk about that. Okay. Let's just clarify this. So Colonel Raymond Lachica is the commander of the Vice Presidential Security Group, okay? Colonel Dennis Nolasco is DepEd's designated security officer appointed by Lachica.
Okay. Okay.
So ang tanong po, these officers, given that they're part of the security, are they allowed to handle confidential funds?
The way I look at it, and the way I understood the joint memorandum circular, is for the confidential funds. For example, DepEd, the office has to partner with other agency for the utilization of these funds. Meaning to say, for example, I'll give you an example. When you are purchasing an information, you have to have an agency partner, right? And when you are using the confidential funds to pay as a reward payment for an information gathered, you also have an agency that you need to partner, because you have a third party verify and give you certificate that such program has been implemented, and these are the certain amounts used from these confidential funds, and these are the informants that were paid. No?
Okay.
But they are all organic within the OVP and the DepEd. So I don't know how they handle that.
Okay, but actually it's so layered, because number one, it's so clear what confidential funds are used for, right? You buy information, right? You house witnesses. It was enumerated on Head Start. So it baffles the mind why Congress would frankly give that much confidential funds to the Office of the Vice President and the DepEd, which are civilian agencies. So dun lang malinay. Dun lang. Alam na natin saan ginagastos ang confidential funds. Binigyan pa ito ng Kongreso. But that's the first layer, all right? So let's move now to the second layer, because Congress has to be accountable for this too. This is where Congress plays politics. Lenny Robredo didn't have confidential funds. Here's a VP who asks for it. Binigay nyo, right? So that's, for me as a taxpayer, that's what alarms me the most. One, right? The discretion of Congress to give confidential funds to agencies that don't do that kind of work. Hindi naman dapat nag-iimbestiga ang OVP at ang DepEd, di ba? Hindi naman dapat bumibili yan ng impormasyon at nag-house ng testigo. Number one. O number two. Number two, so nagawa na. She has it. So ang tanong ngayon, eto sir. She has military men that are disbursing the confidential funds. That's the second layer of alarm, right? Two military officers assigned to OVP and DepEd, sa kanila pumupunta ang pera. So ang tanong ko nga is, why? Number three, yung people like Mary Grace Tiatos, yung sinabi niyo pang isa kanina, do they exist? Do they exist, sir?
Yeah, let me answer. Number one po, yung first alarm is sinabi ko. I wasn't part of the previous Congress, but VP Lenny, to be fair, VP Lenny did not ask for confidential funds. Number two, confidential funds asked by this current vice president. And again, we approved that in good faith. We thought that because there's a joint circular memorandum insofar as the expenses and releases, and they would religiously and faithfully comply with that. Number three, the exact question is, what was your third question, Ma'am Karen?
My second question is the fact that you're discovering now that they're released, essentially. There's a trail of release. It lands with military men. I mean, they are assigned to her office, but they're members of the military, right?
Yeah. So that's the reason why we want to have them in the next committee hearing. Because the only way to find out is to hear their testimonies. No? What's their participation? And how come a certain Mary Grace Piatos came out as one of the signatory in one of the acknowledgement receipts? How come Coke Villamin appears to have received a certain amount from the DepEd and from the office of the vice president, whose signatures somehow different from one another, if you compare both the acknowledgement receipts? Why are there so many names, fictitious, and why there's no attachment to it? That's why the COA has to issue an audit memorandum, observation memorandum, simply because there's no enough attachment to comply with the circular, joint circular. You only have ERs. But how would you know, for example, that Mary Grace Piatos is indeed as a real person and not a made-up character? So the only way for you to find out...
But did they give an address, sir? Did they give identification? May binigay ba silang details?
Wala. Acknowledgement receipts lang po. Pirma. Sometimes may date, sometimes wala pong date, sometimes yung place where the disbursement happened and took place. So yun lang po yung actually yung nakikita namin. In fact, in the previous hearing, if you watch it po, Ma'am Karen, Congressman Roch Gutierrez asked COA, because at the time, these four accountable officers were not present at the time. They said they're on travel. And so they asked COA, would it be possible that eight locations were identified according to the receipts, the acknowledgement receipts, or identified as a location where this disbursement took place in one day in Luzon, in Mindanao? So the logic would dictate that would be impossible, you know, physically impossible. So those are the questions that we want to ask and we want to be clarified with. And so up to now, so many things as we go along, instead of answers, there are a lot of questions. You know, we mas nanganganak yung mga tanong at nanganganak yung mga tanong. So it's very unfortunate that all of these revelations came out. You know, we don't, Karen, we do not want to paint a picture where there seems to be a disconnect in the way a certain agency runs its affairs, especially if it concerns about the second highest office in the land. But we have to do that because there's already, if the COA has already flagged a certain amount. And our job, sabi ko nga, if I go back to your question, why did you have to approve that in the first place? So that actually a way to in effect, a self-reflecting manner in a way in how we utilize this, that would also guide us because tama nga, bakit we approve that in good faith?
Yan.
We approve that.
The words in good faith are not good enough. You know what? In good faith is not good enough for the money of the people. These are the taxpayers' money. What we want is wisdom, accountability, responsibility. It's not in good faith, right? So ang tanong ko, this is in aid of legislation. Can you legislate actually that you do not grant confidential funds agencies that are not Intel related, for example, diba? You had the DICT that was asking for Intel confidential funds. Nahirapan sila. Mm-hmm. I remember I had the DICT here. And when you think about cybersecurity in this country, they needed it more. And yet, where did it go? It went to the OBP. You see what I mean? Agencies that genuinely need the Intel funds, they did not have a lot. And yet, there was politics in granting the confidential funds. So here's Sara Duterte say, you gave it to me, right?
Go back to your, you know, to the issue of holding ourselves accountable. No.
Yes. I think Congress should be made accountable. You guys gave the confidential funds to a civilian agency.
Exactly the reason why we're holding this inquiry, precisely because there's also a self-correction in a way that needed to be in place, right? In the way we appreciate requests. In the first place, when we receive the funds It has already been under the NEP, and then that's the reason why we hold the committee hearing every time that we have the budget cycle, precisely because we want to find out how the justification and the reason why certain agencies needed this certain amount for confidential funds. Current confidential fund is not intrinsically evil. It's how you spend it that makes it bad.
No, but it's also who's spending it.
I know, but
it's
on
very
my part,
clear, but it's so limited how you can spend it, huh?
I know,
it's so limited. Yeah, it's not limitless.
Yeah, but there's the joint circular which guarantees us that usage of these confidential funds would be faithfully and effectively implemented because of joint circular, right? And number two, on my end, you asked me what are the possible legislations that will come out from this hearing. From my end, I agree with you. I agree with you 100%. Eight civilian agencies that do not need confidential funds must. We have to make sure that they will not receive any single cent, right? Mm. That's not from my end. And number two, joint circular has to be institutionalized if we are to discuss about confidential funds. It's no longer a matter of administrative agreements between and among agencies. Mm. There has to be a clear set of rules, institutionalized, legislated, so that we will avoid any abuses that we have seen in the issue of the confi funds for DepEd and OVP, right? Mm. Number three, we have to streamline on how really the COA request for the acknowledgement, not just for the confidential funds, even for the regular funds. In fact, Karen, mas stricto pa nga sila sa mga regular funds, eh. Diba? So we really have to make it to a point that the utilization report and the way to utilize that and audit that COA we should not be settled with just mere acknowledgement receipts. So there are a lot of avenues and a lot of possible legislation that we can come up after we are done with this investigation. But first, we need to know exactly what happened. Because the way
where it was spent,
the way we can produce a sound legislation would be to exactly know what really happened and not to leave any stone unturned.
All right. Yeah. Well, sir, I could talk to you even more, but we don't have enough time. But I do hope you can come back on KedStart because I know the hearing will be ongoing. Thank you so much for joining me today, Congressman Zia Alonto Adiong. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Ma'am Karen. Good morning, po.